Hey guys, it's Dan here from PixelFix and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to talk about Laravel policies and I'll be showing you four ways how we can implement a policy. Now you may ask, what is a policy? A policy is a way for us to restrict certain actions that happen on our model. For example, we can restrict who can create, who can update, who can delete, whatever action you want to perform on your model, you can restrict that action through a policy. So today we are going to create a policy to restrict the actions on our customer's model. Now guys, if you're not sure how we got to this point in our application, I'll leave a link in the description below to the previous episodes that lead up to this part in our application. All right, so let's start off by creating our policy. And we can do this by calling php artisan make policy. And now this is where the important part comes in. Because Laravel is so awesome, we can follow naming conventions that will help us to map our policy with our model. We can call it customer, and then we need to suffix the name with the word policy. And then we can pass in the model flag, and we can specify our model as being customer. All right, so if we didn't follow naming conventions and we've named it something totally different, we can still make it work by linking the model with the policy. And we do this in our auth service provider in the policies property. Now, in order for us to do this, we need to link the model with the policy. Now, there's two ways you can specify it in the policies property. You can either use the string convention, or you can use the namespace class name convention. I'm pretty sure there's more sophisticated names for it, but I just call it the string convention and the namespace class convention. But seeing that we followed naming conventions, we do not need to map these to work. We can basically ignore it. Okay, so now if we look at our policy methods, you'll see that we've got methods called view any, view, create, update, delete, restore, and force delete. Now, these are not the only methods you can use. You can also specify your own methods, but we'll cover that a little bit later. Now, for instance, your view any, if you go to the Laravel documentation, so for example, your policy method would be view any, and that would automatically be mapped to the controller method index. Same with view would be mapped to show, create, and so on. Now that we've created our policy, let's create some authorization. So for our first example, we're going to restrict who would be able to call the index method to show the list of customers. So currently in our application, we've got an administrator role and we've got a user role. So in this example, we're going to place a limit on the index route so that only the administrators would be able to see a whole list of customers. And we can do this by returning the user. Now, the user that's being passed in here, that will always be the authenticated user. So the user that has provided the username and password, we've done the authentication. So in this case, we would check to see if the user has a role called administrator. Okay, so this method has role is a custom method we've implemented on our user model. So if we go to our user model, you'll see this method takes in the role that we send it, it lowercase it, then it compares it to the name of the current role assigned, and then it will return a boolean true or false. So back in our policy, this would then return if the user has a role called administrator, then it would return true, meaning that we allow currently logged in user to access the view any policy method. Now, as we know, the view any policy, it would be mapped to the index method. All right, so let's go ahead and implement our index method. First of all, let's go to our routes file and create our route. We call it the get route to the customers. And then we'll call our customer controller. And we'll call the index route. We'll then give it a name of customers.index. And then if we go to our controller, we can say we need a public function and we call it index. So what we would return here would be a new customer collection. Okay, it seems like we don't have a collection yet. So let's quickly set up a customer collection. PHP artisan make resource. And we'll call it customer collection. And we'll pass in the collection flag. Okay, so now that we have our customer collection, we can say we want to pass in the customer collection. And for now, what we can do is just call the customer model and we'll return all the fields. Okay, so now that we've set up the index method, there's two things that we still need to do. Firstly, let's go back to the API routes file. Now, in order for our policies to work, you need to pass authentication. Now, in order to pass on authentication, you need to apply the sanctum middleware to the route. So let's set up the sanctum middleware, and we do that by calling auth sanctum. So we'll just do it on the route specifically, and we'll say middleware auth sanctum. And the second thing we need to do is to use the actual policy. And we can do this in the method itself by calling this dot authorize, and then you'll see we need to authorize the ability. So the ability would be, in this case, view any. Because the index route is not associated to a specific model, all we need to pass in as the second parameter is basically the customer class. This will tell the authorize method to use the policy assigned to this class. Okay, so let's save our file, head over to Postman to see this in action. So currently we're not logged in. So if we visit our route, right, let's just quickly add the headers. I forgot to add those. That'll be application. Right, so now if we send it again, then we get the message we are not authenticated because we are not currently logged in. All right, so let's first log in with a user called user. Okay, so we've successfully logged in because we've received our JWT token, and if we look at our cookies, we've received our JWT cookie. Now if we go back to that same route, so we should expect to see a 403 forbidden error. And there we go. We've got the 403, and it says this action is unauthorized, meaning that we're not authorized to view that resource. All right, so quickly let's delete our cookie. And let's go back to our login. Let's change this to admin and log in again. Okay, now if we go back to that same route, and there we go, it is empty, but it means that we did receive some kind of information back. We've received the 200 status. So let's quickly create a customer. We'll just call it PixelFix, and we've got a contact number. Address type is a building address, and it's 1234 Point Street. And let's say we live in Sydney, and our postal code is 12345. Okay, so now we've created our customer. Now if we go back to that route, we'll see we get the customer as a result. Okay, so that was method one. Directly using the authorized method inside the controller method. But using it this way is not really an effective way to do it, because you'll need to call the authorize method for every method inside your controller you wish to secure using a policy. That means a lot of code duplication. So a better way to do this is to call the authorize method inside your constructor. And we can do this by set up our constructor. Construct. Okay. And then inside the constructor, we would then call this dot authorize resource. And then we would pass in the model, which would be customer class. Now, this is what I said earlier, where all your policy methods would automatically be mapped to your controller methods. This way, you do not need to manually authorize each method inside your controller. It's done automatically through the use of this authorize resource. Okay, so let's head over to Postman to see this in action. So we are still logged in as our administrator, so we should expect to see the same result if we send our information again. And there we go. We still get a 200 response with the same data that's being returned. All right, so let's delete our cookie and log in as a normal user. All right, successfully logged in, and now we should expect to see a 403 error. And there we go. This action is unauthorized, and we receive the 403 forbidden error. Okay, so that was the second way to do it, is through the use of the authorized resource method inside of your constructor. Now, the third way to do it would be in the API routes file by using a middleware on the route. So in this section where we defined the sanctum middleware, what we're going to do is we're going to add another middleware called can with a colon, and then the first parameter that you will need to pass is the policy action, which would be view any, and the second one would be the model that you want to authorize. But because we're not having a specific model in this case, or an instance of a model, we just need to provide the model class name. In this case, it would be app models customer. Okay, so let's head over to Postman to check this in action again. So again, we're logged in as the user, so if we refresh our data, we should expect to get the same 403 error. And there we go, still get the 403, and this action is unauthorized. Okay, so if we go again, delete our cookie, and go to the login, change our user account to admin, log in successfully, go back to our route, and we should get a 200 response and our customer that's been created. Okay, so that was the third way of doing it, by specifying the can middleware inside your route. Now, the fourth way of doing it is, let's just make a copy of this. We'll comment one out. Well, let's comment this one out just for reference. And we'll remove this middleware, and now we can chain can method, and again your first parameter would be the ability, which would be view any, and then your second parameter would be your model instance, depending on the route you use, or if your route does not include a specific model instance, you would then use the class name, again, which would be customer class. And that should be it. Let's head over to Postman to check this out. So again, we're still logged in as the administrator and we should expect to see another 200. And there we go. We still hit get 200 with our data returned. So let's just double check. We delete our cookie. We log in as a normal user. Okay, successful login. Go back to the customers and we should expect to see the 403 error. And there we go. 403 forbidden. This action is unauthorized. Okay, so that was the four ways we can implement a policy into our application to secure the actions on our model. So to recap, the first way you can do it is through the authorize method inside your controller method itself. But like I said, that's not a very efficient way to do it because you're going to have to do it for every single controller method. The second way to do it is through the construct method in your controller, and that will automatically map your policy methods to your controller methods. And the third way to do it is in the routes file itself by using the CAN middleware. And then the fourth way you can do it is using the CAN method with the same action. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. And I really hope you found this informative and this will help you to understand Laravel policies a little bit better. And yeah, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing. It would really help me out. And yeah, until the next episode, guys. See you later.